This is a classic example of solving for the resultant force using knowledge from basic trigonometry. There is a 60 degree angle between two forces, 300 newtons and 400 newtons respectively. We can draw an imaginary line opposite to the 60 degree angle to form a right triangle. We can solve for the length of the imaginary line opposite to the 60 degree angle using the relationship sine 60 degrees is equal to y over the hypotenuse, which is 300 newtons. Y, therefore, is equal to square root of 3 over 2 times 300. Or simply, square root of 3 times 150 newtons. We will proceed to solve for the value of x using the relationship cosine 60 is equal to x over 300 newtons. We know that the value of cosine 60 is 1/2. We multiply this one with 300. This is equal to x, or x is equal to 150 newtons. Then we will draw lines that are parallel to the given forces. These lines are not necessarily be of the same length of the original arrows, because they are sketches to trace the resultant force. We have here a parallelogram. By drawing a line from the vertex between 300 newtons and 400 newtons and extending it to the vertex of the imaginary lines, the path of the resultant force is now obvious. But we have to solve for its magnitude using the values that we estimated earlier. We will draw a vertical line to the vertex of the imaginary lines. The new vertical line is parallel to the y line that we sketched earlier. By extending this line downwards, it will become perpendicular to the path of the 400 newton force. Extending the path of the 400 newton force to meet the vertical line, we now have a new right triangle. The extension path of the 400 newton force has the same magnitude of x, and the vertical line has the same magnitude as that of y. We can solve for the magnitude of the resultant force using the Pythagorean formula. Rf is equal to the square root of 3 times 150 quantity squared plus 550 squared. Rf is equal to 608 newtons. Its direction is going northeast.